Yesterday we have started the revision of the list chapter. So I am continuing with the same. We were discussing the methods of the list. I revise again all the methods. I have list with the elements 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. 21, 22, 23, 24, 25. This is the list, okay? And I am to apply various methods of the list. First method is length method. Length method is used to find the length of the object or the length of the sequence which is passed as parameter inside this function, okay? Whichever sequence you passed, it will find the length of that particular parameter. Clear? So if I press the enter key, the length will be 10 because there are total 10 elements in the list. Clear to all? All right. Now next is list method. List method is a constructor method that is used to create a list from some other object. You may have string, you may have tuple, or you may have list. When you apply, when you pass that sequence, that object inside the list method, it will convert it into list. Suppose I have a string W with the name India. Indians are good. This is the string which I have. Indians are good. Now, what I did is I pass this list, this string in the list function, and I am giving the name of the list as A. I have passed the string W, the sequence W, as a parameter inside the list function. Now, list function, which is a constructor function, it will create the list from this string. When I print A, it will be print like this. Each character of string will act as one element of the list. Each character of the string will act as one element of the list. If you are looking it carefully, just notice space is also treated as one element. I hope it is very much visible and clear to all. Space is also being treated as one single element of the list. Okay? Then if you are taking into consideration a tuple, I am taking tuple here, 11, 12, 13, 14, and I pass this tuple as a parameter inside this list function, it will convert it into list. The tuple has been converted into list. Clear? All right. Then the next method which we are to see is index method. Index method is used to find index of any particular element which is residing in your list. I have, suppose I am to find index of element 21. It is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. 5 means 6. 5 means 6. Clear to all? Then if I am finding the index of element 11, it is 0. The very first element of list L. Look at the topmost list. Don't look at the other list. This list. I am applying all methods on this very list. So concentrate on that list, okay? Now I am going to find the index of the element which does not exist in the list. Python will raise error, value error. When you try to find the index of the element which is not available in the list, Python will raise an error, that is value error, 20 not in the list. Clear to all up till here? All right. Then we have next method as append method. Append method is used to add an element at the end of the given list. But append method has one restriction. Anybody can tell me what is that restriction? There is one limitation or restriction on the append method. Oh, Ashutosh Kalia in the lecture. Yes, Ashutosh Kalia.
Sir, we cannot append multiple elements.
Good.
So thank you, sir.
You are back to the online classes. L dot append. I am passing 20. If I print L here, check it out. 20 is added at the end of the list. 20 is added at the end of the existing list. Okay. Now, if I say L dot append 30 comma 31. Python raises an error. Why Python raises an error? You cannot add multiple elements in the given list with the help of append function. At a time, you can insert or add only one element. This is the drawback or restriction on append function. Now see another case. 30 and 31 as a list. Now see, Python has not raised any error. Python has not raised any error because what Python treats, when you pass a list of elements in append function, Python treat it as a nested element. This is treated as a nested element. Okay. And it is considered to be one element of list L. It is considered as one single element of list L. Anybody can tell me right now what will be the length of the list L? If I look into the last final list L, what will be the length? Yes, please. Yes, Harshvardhan, unmute yourself.
Sir, 12.
Length of L, 12. Okay, clear? All right. You have some doubt, Harshvardhan? All right. Now, moving to the next method, that is your extend method. Now, extend method is different from append method. With the help of extend method, you can insert multiple elements at the end of the existing list. As it was a restriction on append, the same problem is removed by using the extend method. Okay, with the help of extend method, you can insert multiple elements in the list. Clear to all? Like suppose I have a list A with the elements 32, 33, 34. and I use the extend method and I pass this list as parameter. Check it out. Check the result, all of you. There was one list A which was having three elements. This was one structure, one sequence, and the entire sequence I passed as parameter inside the extend method, and you check here, multiple elements are inserted. Multiple elements are inserted. Okay? Am I clear? Now, if I say L dot extend, I say 5, 6, 7, 8, and I say list L. Check it out. Four elements more are inserted in the list. Up till here, any doubt, any queries by anyone? All right. So who will revise quickly the difference in append and extend? Anyone who can quickly conclude the difference between append and extend? Yes, Devanshi, unmute yourself.
Sir, in the append method, we can add only one element at the end of the list. And in the extend method, we can add multiple elements at the end of the list.
Okay. Okay. Now see this. L dot extend. I am giving element 2 over here. With the help of extend method, if you try to insert a single element, Python will raise an error. This is in contradiction to append. Append mein agar aap multiple elements insert karne ki koshish karte the, Python used to raise an error. But in extend method, if you try to insert a single element, Python will raise an error. Because right now, Python is not treating it as a sequence. Python is treating 2 as integer. So extend function always take parameter as some sequence. Okay? Clear? Not a single element. That is why Python has raised an error over here. Clear? Now proceeding to the next function of list, that is insert function. As we have studied that with the help of append and extend, you are inserting element at the end only. With the help of insert function, you can insert element anywhere at any position in the list. I say A dot insert. At second position, I want 35. Print A. Check it out. This is your A list. Okay. And using the insert function take two parameters. Insert function takes two parameters. First parameter is the index, the location, the position where you want to insert. Second parameter is the value, the element which actually you want to place. Am I clear to all? The role of insert function. Okay. So this is your insert function. Now anybody could revise the difference between append, extend and insert? Collectively append and extend and difference in insert. Always the same hands. Yes, Riddhi, you unmute yourself.
Sir, in append and extend, the element can be added only at the end position, and in insert, we can add any element at any position.
Okay, okay. I am saying A dot insert 0, 10. I put A here. 10 is inserted at the first position, that is at the zeroth position. At the zeroth position. Now, if I say A dot insert length of A, comma 40. अब 40 कहां इंसर्ट हुआ? 40 कहां इंसर्ट हुआ? लिस्ट के एंड में. लिस्ट के एंड में. बिकॉज व्हाट इंडेक्स आई हैव पास्ड? द कंप्लीट लेंथ ऑफ द स्ट्रिंग. ओके, गॉट इट? नाउ नेक्स्ट मेथड इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट मेथड, दैट इज द पॉप मेथड. When you are using the pop method, you must be knowing the index of the element which you want to pop. I have a question over here. In simple journal sense, don't come in the computer terms. What is the meaning of pop? I expect some other student to participate. Every time the same hands are raised. Other candidates also, please participate in the online lecture. Then only you will get the benefit when you are involving yourself in the lecture. If just listening to the answers of others, that makes no sense. Yes, please. What is the simple meaning of the word pop? English पढ़ते हो, इंग्लिश आती भी है, इतना मैंने डिफिकल्ट वर्ड तो पूछ नहीं लिया कुछ. यस मयंक, अनम्यूट योरसेल्फ.
सर, टू पॉप मींस टू टेक आउट एनी एलिमेंट फ्रॉम अ लिस्ट.
टेक आउट एनी एलिमेंट फ्रॉम द लिस्ट, ओके, आई एग्री विद यू. एनी अदर चाइल्ड विद सम अदर मीनिंग? मयंक, इट्स ओके, पुट योर हैंड डाउन. Any other child with some other meaning? Yes, Ashutosh.
Sir, suddenly open.
Suddenly open? No, Ashutosh, you are not correct over here. Yes, anybody else? Gurjot Singh, what are your views? Again, he is not here in the class.
Sir, to
what?
Take a element out of the list or the tuple.
To remove.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay. Mute yourself. So, I am having a dot pop. I am passing 1 as the index. 1 means 2. 1 means 2. Okay? To remove the element which is lying at second index, at second position, pop kya karta hai? Pop function will remove the element, but it will return the element. It not only removes, but it also return back the element. It displays the deleted element. Check out. 32 was lying at position 1. Same 32 has been displayed by the pop function. Now if you print the list, 32 won't be visible. It will be eliminated from the list. Okay. Got it? Now I am saying pop 7. I have passed that index to remove the element which does not exist. Python will raise error, index error, out of range error. When you try to remove the element from that very index which does not exist in your structure, in your sequence, Python will raise an error. Now if I say pop, I don't pass any index. ये चीज आपके प्लस टू में काम आएगी आपको, अगर पॉप फंक्शन के अंदर हमने कुछ भी पास नहीं किया. आई एम नॉट पासिंग एनी इंडेक्स इन द पॉप फंक्शन. बाय डिफॉल्ट इट विल ऑलवेज रिमूव द लास्ट एलिमेंट. एवरी टाइम व्हेन यू आर गिविंग द पॉप फंक्शन विद एम्प्टी ब्रैकेट्स विदाउट पासिंग एनी इंडेक्स, पॉप फंक्शन विल ऑलवेज एंड ऑलवेज इरेडिकेट द लास्ट एलिमेंट ऑफ द लिस्ट. चेक आउट, 40 इज लाइंग एट द लास्ट. Now, if I print list, the list is this. अच्छा, अगर मैं अब pop function चलाऊं बिना index के, which element will be removed? If now I run the pop function without passing the index, which element will be removed? Yes, Riddhi.
Sir, 34.
Too nice. 34. Okay. A dot pop. 34. Clear hai ji? Okay. Now proceeding to the next function of the list, that is remove function. Just now I told you that in the pop method, you need to know the index, the position of the element which you want to delete. Okay. And it return or display the element, the deleted element. But there can be some situations where you are unaware about the index of the element that you want to remove. There we use the remove function. Unlike pop function, which return back the element which is deleted, remove function doesn't return it back. Pop method takes the index of the element as a parameter. Remove method directly take the element, not the index. I am displaying the original list which I have taken in the last just in the previous lecture. Okay, now I say L dot remove 12. Usne return to nahi kiya. Achha, ek aur baat. Suppose 12 is occurring multiple times. 12 value is being repeated multiple times in the list. The first occurrence of that element will get removed by the remove function. Aapka 12 element 3-4 baar repeat ho raha hai. Jo uski pehli occurrence hai na, remove function se wo remove hogi. Baki occurrences ko effect nahi hoga. Now I print the list. Check out, 12 is removed. List ko shuru se dekho, right from the beginning, 12 is removed. But unlike pop method, it has not display the element. Okay? Now I am removing 8. Oh, sorry. Okay? Now I am removing 20. Got it? Now I try to remove an element which does not exist in the list. Python raises an error. Python raises an error. You tried to remove the element which is not in the list. Python raises an error. Clear? So you must know at which situations Python display which type of error. This is very much important. You must be aware about the type of error being returned by Python at all the relevant situations. Right? Then only you will get benefit of the programming. Now, next is we are going with the clear method. Now, clear method also does the deletion part, but clear method clears the list sequence. The list object is not terminated, the list becomes empty. Okay, I say L. A dot clear. list is empty. But here you might have noticed one thing very carefully. The list object still exists. List ke elements remove hue hai. List object remove nahi hua. List abhi bhi hai. Us naam ki list abhi bhi hai. Only the elements of that particular sequence are removed. Can you reinsert element in this list? How? I want to again fill this list. How I can fill? Yes, anyone? Yes, Ashutosh.
Sir, using append method.
Okay, what else? Good. Or koi option? Yes, Riddhi.
Sir, extend method use karke hum multiple elements add kar sakte hain.
Okay, nice. Third option. थर्ड ऑप्शन रुको मैं जरा बच्चे को अनम्यूट करता हूं तरुण आप बताइए अनम्यूट योरसेल्फ तरुण
एक्सटेंड मेथड यूज करें
बेटा एक्सटेंड तो बता दिया अपेंड बता दिया इज देयर एनी थर्ड वे यू कैन इंसर्ट द एलिमेंट बच्चे
इंसर्ट मेथड
वेरी गुड शाबाश टू नाइस आई वाज वेटिंग फॉर दिस रिस्पांस एक्सीलेंट रिस्पांस तरुण इंसर्ट मेथड से A dot insert at zero position. I want 11. Ye dekho. Okay. Got it. So clear method is used to remove all the items or elements from the list, but list remains there. List object doesn't get deleted. Now the next method, the next statement is DEL. When you use DEL statement, the list object get terminate. List exist no more. DELA. You try to print A now. The Python will raise error. DEL statement, DEL keyword bhi hai, dekho, orange color ka color aa raha hai. Ye keyword bhi hai. DEL statement. When used with the sequence, it totally destroys the sequence. Even the object of this name does not exist. Just in front of you, I have done. I delete the list A. Then I tried my level best to print A list, but I couldn't display because that object with that name has been terminated. Now I want anyone willingly to come on the video and tell me the difference between clear method and delete statement. Anyone willingly come on the video and discuss it. Yes, Divanshi, please.
Sir, clear method will clear the elements of the list and DEL statement will clear the entire list.
Okay. Anybody else with some different idea? Yes, Mayank, what are your views?
Sir, Divanshi ne jo kaha wo bhi sahi hai aur delete method after deletes the list aur fir error dikhata hai aur clear empty list dikhata hai.
When you print the list after using clear method, it will show empty list. But when you print the list object after DEL statement, it will show error because the list with that name doesn't exist anymore. It destroys the list object also. Clear method doesn't destroy the list object. Too nice. Good. Good response. Okay. Coming to the next method, count method. Count method just you have used in the previous lectures when I was discussing the programs of list. Sorry. It checks and count the occurrence of any particular element in the list, that how many times this element is occurring in the structure. I say L dot count. L is capital. L dot count 14. 14 is occurring only once. 14 is occurring only once. So answer is 1. Now I take a list over here where I'm going to take multiple element which is occurring multiple times, so that count function works more better. Okay. Here you can see 12 is occurring 4 times. A dot count 12. The result is 4. Okay. Now I am trying to find the element which does not exist in the list. Will Python raise an error? Python will not raise any error, rather it will print 0 by default. Python will not raise any error, rather it will print 0 by default. Okay? Clear? The same concept you have used in the last program that I discussed in the last lecture, where you were to remove the element which is occurring multiple number of times, if you remember the lecture. The same code you have transferred in the practical file also. Am I clear? Am I right? Okay. Now moving to the next method is your reverse method. The reverse method is used to reverse the item of the list. It is used to reverse the item of the list. I say A dot reverse. A. Check it out. Check karo. Compare the original A list with the given reverse list produced by using the reverse function. Okay. Clear to all? Then next we have is the sort method. Okay. Clear? Now, what is the general meaning of sort? Sorting. Who will tell? Divanshi. Again, Divanshi. Divanshi, put your hand down. Every time, why you... Yuvraj. Yes, Yuvraj. Unmute yourself, bete.
Sir, generally sorting matlab arrangement or computer language means ascending order, descending order.
आप कंप्यूटर टर्म छोड़ दो, आप जर्नल एक लेमैन को अगर समझाना हो कि सॉर्टिंग क्या है, आप उसको कैसे समझाओगे?
लीव अरेंजमेंट करना प्रॉपर तरीके से,
अरेंजमेंट ऑफ आइटम्स इन एनी पर्टिकुलर ऑर्डर, वेदर असेंडिंग और डिसेंडिंग.
डिसेंडिंग,
या राइट, गुड. ओके, सो इफ आई से ए डॉट सॉर्ट एंड आई प्रिंट ए हियर, सी what is the default ordering? Ascending. Default ordering is ascending. Check out. The default ordering is ascending. Okay. Now, if I want to print in descending order, I have to say A dot sort bracket reverse is true. Ye dekho. Upper side with this command, whenever you will give this command, it will sort the element of the list in ascending order, but it has not created any new list. Usne A list ko sort to kiya, lekin usne koi nayi list nahi create kar di sort karke. Hum usi list mein hai. We are in the same list A. It has not created any other list after sorting it. Okay, when you want to print in descending order, the extra command, the extra parameter which you have to pass is reverse equal to true. Whenever you will give this command, it will always print the structure in the descending order. Again, I'm telling you, with the sort method, a new structure, a new list is not created. We are in the same structure. Right? Got it, all of you? Okay. Then there is another method called sorted method. One is sort, one is sorted. Anybody can tell me the difference? If you remember the previous lectures, sort and sorted. Yes, Japan Jodh, what are your views?
Sir, in sorted method, a new list will be generated.
Yes, a new list will be generated. X equal to sorted bracket A. Print X. Check it out. Check it out. Okay. Clear to everyone? All right.